What the gel? We're gonna show you how simply changing a gel on your rim light can change the look of the entire image. Let's get started, see what we can do. You may or may not know, but we have an online business coaching class of people come together from all over the world once a month to talk about their businesses. Well, on September 28th at 5 p.m., we're gonna allow everyone to come in on that free call. We're gonna introduce the daily routine for success. You can see what we're doing there. Can see how it's helping people to grow their businesses. So go to theslendlands.com where you can sign up to join us for that call. It'll help you change your business. Hi, this is JP Morgan. Today on The Slant Lens, we're gonna take a look at how changing the gels on your rim light changes the look and the feel of the entire image. The reason we chose the rim light and not your key light is because if you put gels on your key light, like a nice green, then it's gonna turn Mr. Oliver Goodwill green. We don't want that. But if we put it on the backlight or our rim light, it's gonna rim him and it changes also the atmosphere in the room. So this works extremely well if you're putting this gel through smoke because the smoke in the air and the atmosphere changes kind of the color palette of the entire background. If you don't have smoke in the air, it's not gonna work as well. You're gonna have to aim it at your background. We're not using a smoke machine in the room, we're using a V-Hazer by Roscoe. It just gives you a nice kind of haze in the room, which is much different than smoke. You can get a similar kind of look by just turning your smoke on and off and really fanning it. But if you have a hazer, it's fabulous. But you can get that look with a smoke machine. Just really fan the smoke, spread it out so it doesn't look chunky or fill or air, and it'll give you that kind of look as well. When I choose my gels, I start like this. First off, I've got a greenish color background. So I'm gonna look at all my gels that have different green colors, and I'm gonna start with those. I'm gonna cycle through those. Here's a green, which one of those looks good? Which one feels right? Which one's going to blend his clothing, which is kind of greenish, to the background, which is green? So I start with a greenish color. Then I thought, well, maybe I'll look at some straw. See what a straw does. How's a straw going to change the look of this image? How's it going to change the feel? Now it feels more like a sunlight. It feels more, it's pretty heavy. So maybe we go to a half straw or a quarter straw to see how that affects the image in the background. Then the last one is always fun to look at is just some kind of pinkish colors. Those pinkish colors are going to bring up a little bit of the tonal value of his skin, and it's going to blend with him and be a lot more subtle. The heavy pinks are going to be heavy, the lighter pinks are going to kind of blend more with the background. That's just the color palette we have going on here. If you have a different situation, you may want to go in more into the blues, which we shot some of the blues just to look at, but just audition them. And what it means to audition them is you just hand hold them in front of your rim light and take a shot and see if it works. And go through a bunch of them and see which one you like. Kate laughed when we pulled out the industrial vapor gel, which is kind of a greenish, kind of warm gel. It's kind of interesting. But when we put that on there, I like the look of that a lot, and that's probably where we're gonna start. The hardest thing about choosing gels is there are a lot of options. Choose gels that fit into the color palette of the image you're working on, and then go through and go, okay, here's a two or three I really like, or maybe the one or two you really like, and commit yourself to that. If you just go through gel after gel after gel, you start to chase yourself in a circle. So find a gel you like, pick that one, or pick maybe two, and shoot your image like that, and it'll look good. I absolutely love these gel packs from Roscoe for a couple of reasons. One, they're small, they're really inexpensive. You can buy several different gel packs. You can audition them really quickly. Take a look, tell us which ones that you like. Actually, there's a group of you out there who will have to tell us which ones you really don't like. We love all the trolls too. Hugs for the trolls. Take a look at all the gels and tell us which ones you like. So keep those cameras rolling, keep on clicking. We've got a great giveaway here in September. We've got the Baja A6 by Dynalite, fabulous strobe head. We've got a grand softbox and a speed ring. It's a complete kit, $950 value. Go to theslendlens.com and sign up. Subscribe to The Slanted Lens. Join us for all the exciting things we have going on, like me with weird hats on my head.